A few days ago, I was invited to post a video with my thoughts on why I think the movement for indefinite life extension is important, and to answer a question whether I personally would accept an indefinite lifespan should one be available. And of course, for me, the answer is obvious. Yes, I would accept an indefinite lifespan, just by virtue of it offering me more choice than I have right now with my current fixed lifespan. I mean, if I don't like it, I can always end it. And that flexibility is unavailable right now. Right now, we don't get to decide how long we get to live. We are actually hostages of our biology. It's our genes that decide how long we get to live, as they do for all the replicators, like starting from bacteria to mice, to men, to whales, to whatever. And so we're essentially like hostages on death row, who are guaranteed to die within, you know, 80 to 100 years, pretty much. I mean, the odds of living past 100 years are 1 in a million, and statistically, no one has ever lived past 122 years. So if nothing changes, I mean, we're guaranteed to die. And not just that, we're guaranteed to suffer. I mean, starting from a certain age, it's the aging process becomes unbearable, and it's painful, and emotionally and physically. And that really sucks. Aging sucks, death sucks, and if we don't do anything about it, we're just going to succumb to it. And I think that's a big problem that we need to acknowledge. And it's kind of odd for me to see that not many people acknowledge that this is a problem. Most people take it for granted now that, you know, aging is part of life and death is a part of life. I mean, they are, but they're a bad part of life, so we should do everything possible to mitigate it or get rid of it. It's funny that most people only start doing something about trying to prolong their lifespan once they find themselves terminally ill with some condition like cancer, when they know that they got only like a year left to live, and so then they start doing everything possible to prolong their life, to get cured of cancer. At that point, they really become life extensionists, because they're trying pretty much anything. They would try anything to get rid of the condition that gives them guaranteed death. But if people aren't sick, for them, guaranteed death within 30 to 50 years is not a big deal for some reason. And to me, that is something that we should try to change in the society with trying to, first of all, educate people that aging is plastic, it's reversible in animals at least. I mean, we've seen this in cells with induced pluripotent stem cells that are actually rejuvenated in some animals, in mice, so that are actually rejuvenated by induction of pluripotency genes. But I'm going off on a tangent. What I really want to say is that for the movement for indefinite life extension to succeed, I think we should instill a sense of urgency in others that we actually are terminally ill. All of us are terminally ill with this genetic condition of aging, which brings us guaranteed death. It's a mortal disease, and we should treat it as such. And I mean, some scientists that specialize in aging kind of have been aware of this, of these pathologies that are at some point amenable to mitigation, to pharmacological manipulation. But now we should translate all those findings, all that research, into humans and do it as fast as possible. Because right now, I mean, it's great that scientists or researchers are doing all that research, and they can be doing it for another decade or two before we can see meaningful translation to the human domain, which I think we don't have that luxury. We don't have that time. I mean, our generation, I mean, if the therapy becomes available in 30 years, we're also going to be pretty late. But think about our parents. Think about our grandparents. Those generations, if we don't hurry up, they face very slim odds of living long enough to be able to extend their lives. And that sucks too. I really don't want anybody to succumb to death and aging, and I really want all generations to be able to benefit from these therapies. And I think these therapies can be, some meaningful life extension can be gained from translation of already existing mechanisms of aging interventions. And this is why we're working on epigenetic rejuvenation right now. So I think if we do instill that sense of urgency in people, we can start changing the society to actually wake up to the problem of aging. And this will create, I think, will create a groundswell of public support for funding primary research into aging mechanisms, and will actually pressure scientists into translating all their findings and doing it as fast as possible. If we give the sense of urgency into the scientists that waiting for another decade or two is not acceptable for us, I think this can really speed things up. And I think a great example of the kind of activism that we should embrace is what has been demonstrated by HIV-infected people back in the 1980s, where initially the diagnosis of HIV was essentially a death sentence, with people only getting 18 months left to live. And they didn't accept the situation. They were very vocal about it, trying to speed things up. They said, hurry up, Mr. Scientists, or hurry up, Mr. Politician, let's fund this research, because we don't have that much time left to live. And if you don't find a cure or some kind of intervention to prolong a life quickly, we're just going to die. And their activism really helped turn the tide on HIV and turned it from a death sentence into a manageable condition that people live for decades now. And they've done it quickly. By the 1990s, already all these retroviral cocktails were helping people live for much longer than initially a year and a half. So I think if we kind of embrace that paradigm of terminally ill people with trying to do translation of research as fast as possible, and trying to convince scientists and politicians in the urgency of finding at least something that can delay aging or fix it outright, I think we have better odds of surviving and helping our loved ones, our parents and grandparents, to also survive long enough to enjoy the real rejuvenation therapies. I hope I didn't ramble on for too long, and hopefully some of that, what I had to say, was useful for at least some people. So that was my perspective. Thanks.